Welcome to a Soundscape tutorial. In this video, we'll be learning about one of the parameters available to us in a Soundscape system, spread. Spread is an input parameter which adjusts the horizontal level distribution for an object across all loudspeakers within a deployment. The spread value can be set per object and is displayed as the yellow crescent at the bottom of a sound object in both R1 and Create Control, as well as this video. As the spread value is increased, or widened, the sound object will play out of more speakers, providing an even level coverage, but at the expense of pinpoint localization. As the spread value is decreased, the sound will be played out of fewer speakers, providing us more pinpoint precise localization at the expense of coverage and possibly headroom. The spread value ranges from 0, focused, to 1, wide, with the default value set at 50%, or 0.5. For most applications, this default value will work best. Let's look at an example. In this scenario, we see our sound object at the front left of the stage. While most audience members are experiencing good localization, those at the front right of the stage are not able to properly hear the object due to the lack of volume coming out of the speakers closest to them for this object. To solve this, we can increase the spread value, widening the object and providing a more even level coverage. Let's learn how to adjust the spread value in D&B software. In R1, while in tuning or show mode, open the DS100 and scene inputs view, then adjust the spread on a per input basis by 0.01 increments. If you want to set all inputs to the same spread value, use the NScene sound object's spread value to control the spread of all objects in an absolute manner. The spread can also be adjusted on an NScene positions view. Again, while in tuning or show mode, open the positions view, then select an object either from the view or from the sound object's list. Then adjust the spread on a per object basis by 0.1 increments. Let's look at how to adjust the spread in Create Control. In the Soundscape view, select a sound object and use the yellow spread fader in the sound object parameters panel to adjust the spread. Multiple objects can also be selected using the Shift key, and the spread value can be adjusted relatively or absolutely for all selected objects. Or the spread value can be adjusted for all objects in a group, again, relatively or absolutely, by selecting the group and adjusting the spread fader. In the Soundscape DAW plugin, simply open the plugin window and drag the spread knob to the left or right. A precise value can also be entered into the field below the knob, and this value can be automated using your DAW's automation features. Now that we have covered spread, let's discuss a complementary function called spread factor. Spread factor is an output parameter which adjusts the spread value for all sound objects within a function group or speaker zone, and is usually set during the initial commissioning of a Soundscape system. While spread is applied to an object, spread factor is applied to a function group, and therefore can only be adjusted in R1. Let's return to our previous example to use as a demonstration. We see that we have the same problem as before, where the listener on the opposite side of the stage from the object can't hear it very well. This time, let's solve the problem using spread factor in R1. The spread factor is a multiplier for the spread value of all objects in a chosen function group or speaker zone. In our scenario, we know that the problem zone is the front fills. So in R1, we locate the front fills function group in the devices page after selecting the DS100, and we see the spread factor value is set to the default of 1. Let's see how the spread factor impacts the spread value of our sound object by doing a little math. I know, but I promise it's easy. The equation to derive the total spread is simply spread value for the object times spread factor equals total spread. In this case, we know our object is using the default spread value of 0.5. Our front fill's function group has a spread factor of 1, which gives us a total spread for our object of 0.5. So we see that the default spread factor of 1 does not impact the spread for this object. The spread value set for the object is the spread value that object will receive when playing through this speaker zone. With the spread factor set at its maximum value of 2, the spread value for each object in the function group will be doubled. Therefore, the default spread value of 0.5 will now become 1 when the object plays through the front fills, without having to change the spread of the objects themselves, which would also affect the mains and all other speaker zones. Now we can see that the issue has been resolved for our listener at the right of the stage, and they're no longer thinking of the ticket and beer prices for this concert. On the inverse, if the spread factor is set to the minimum value of 0.5, the spread value for each object in the front fills will be halved, meaning the default value of 0.5 will now be 0.25. And in this case, most of your audience will think very lowly of your mixing skills. Regardless of the spread factor value, you can still change the spread value for each object individually. And when the object moves into a different speaker zone, it will have that zone's spread factor applied to it, making for an incredibly versatile system. However, just like with the spread value, the default value will work best in most applications. Now let's see where to find the spread factor in R1. It can either be configured while online in a Soundscape-enabled project from the Devices page, Devices tab, Select DS100, Function Groups tab, and Spread Factor Value. Or it can be adjusted on the Soundscape output's remote view, which is automatically generated when opening a Soundscape-enabled DBPR file in R1. To recap, spread is an input parameter, which adjusts the horizontal level distribution across all loudspeakers for a single object. The default value of 0.5 will work best in most applications. The spread factor is an output parameter which adjusts the spread value of all objects within a given function group by a factor of the set value. Again, the default value of 1 will work best for most applications, and if adjustment is required, it will usually be done during the initial commissioning of the Soundscape system. For more information on spread and other Soundscape tips and tricks, check out the Soundscape guidebook, which can be downloaded from dbaudio.com. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching.